Hello everybody, Caden here today with another episode of Minecraft Dinosaurs. And we're back on the good old Dinos World after a little bit of a break from uploading. I don't really have anything else to say about that. But anyway, I don't know why I even mentioned that, but one of the raptors is outside. Which one are you? Oh, it's probably the same one from last time I was on the world. Did I not? Oh no, I think I did have the raptors loaded in a little bit. I thought they would have grown a bit more. Guess they weren't loaded. Anyway, today, guys, we are starting the work on the next project, which I decided to just go ahead with because I was like, I don't know, I want to do it. We are going to start rebuilding the aquarium this episode. And I've already done, well, a decent amount of work. You can already see it. We'll go in there and we'll just sit in here now. This is what I've done to the aquarium since we last saw it. I have basically come in here, I've taken out the entire dome, I've lowered the floor, or most of the floor, I've taken out things, I've filled things in, and yeah, this is where we currently are at for this thing. So, yeah, this is pretty much what we're working with right now. So hopefully I'm going to have concept art. If it's not this episode, hopefully it'll be next episode of what I'm thinking of. Now the concept art, it's not going to be like, you know, oh, this is 100% what's happening. This is going to be kind of like, oh, this is an idea I have. But I've been looking at some actual aquariums recently. And I know I said, oh, I'd like to do maybe a few more outdoor areas. We're still going to do that. But I think a majority of the build is going to be inside some sort of huge building or something like that. Because I was looking at some actual aquariums, such as the ones that have like the whale shark tanks, like I think the one down in Georgia does. Georgia, in the United States. I know they have a whale shark tank down there, and I believe that's in a building. I'm not sure though. Anyway, I've just been looking at tanks and pictures of tanks and things like that to kind of come up with a good idea on what we should do for our own aquarium. And I think I'm starting to get some decent ideas. So yeah, this episode is going to be one that most of you guys probably aren't going to be that interested in. This is going to be another one of, believe it or not, the destruction episodes where we spend 90% of the video just breaking things. Of course, this is, I'd say, rather necessary so that way when we, you know, actually come back and next episode, or, you know, next week, most likely, which actually, for me, is spring break, so maybe we'll get to do some live streams of this series. Yeah, we could probably do a couple live streams to do a bit more work and planning on the aquarium. Heck, we could probably have just an aquarium planning stream. You guys could suggest ideas for what we should do, where certain creatures should go. Yeah, by that point, I'd like to have a concept image so you guys have a real good idea of what I'm thinking. Because I've got some stuff visualized. And the stuff I've got visualized, unfortunately, means we're going to have to destroy a lot of what was natural about this area, and which is one of the reasons we actually picked it here. What was it? Yeah, someone actually was mentioning to me, and I don't know if I remember, I don't remember if I talked about this in the previous episode, that I really shouldn't put anything aquarium-like out here because, well, desert suddenly leading into here. So I was like, you know what? That's a pretty legitimate reason. So I think we're actually going to build something, another building here, something that might be able to tie into the aquarium, maybe like a gift shop or something we build right there. I'm not quite sure at this point, but we are going to be moving a couple of things around. Oh no, we need our trusty axe to go and beat the spider up. Okay, what was I gonna say? So one of the things that's gonna change, and I think it's gonna look much nicer, is we're getting rid of this. And we're not getting rid of the idea, we're just getting rid of this specific circular tank. Reason, it's too small. That's reason number one. Reason one, too small. And reason two, although it was a cool idea to do a spiral staircase going down, I realized I don't really want to do that. I want my aquarium to mostly be on one level until we reach the outdoors, which I think is actually going to, oh gosh. Ugh, that did not go very well. Okay, I really just want to fly real quick. You know what? We're going to go into creative mode real quick, just so I actually can tell you guys exactly what I'm thinking. So I'm thinking this cliffside here, this one that kind of leads over to there, this is all getting taken down to the level the floor is currently at over there. There's going to be a walkway all along here. In the center, instead of the plesiosaurus area, we're going to replace this with an actual cylindrical tank, probably, I'm thinking maybe 16 by 16. I mean, what's this one? This one's about 7 by 7. So nearly twice the size of that tank, right in the very center here. In fact, actually, it might be a bit more over to the side, or we're going to move the entrance over. I'm not quite sure. I want it to actually, yeah, line up with the entrance this time. So there will be a big cylindrical tank kind of back here, and this will take up, we put it right around here, this might actually work better. Oops, put that back, and then, no, we got to delete it. We got to delete the block. Okay, so yeah, move it back here, something like that, to kind of give the aquarium a bit more of a focal point when you enter. We're still gonna keep the skeletons. I'm gonna move them around, change the roof up a bit. And then we've got the Henotis. Enclosure. Now this is going to get completely remodeled because I don't like the current exhibit much. I don't think I did it very well, and I'm actually thinking the Henotis might, if we put this circular tank here, I'm thinking the circular tank we might try and use mo creatures with as well. So that one will strictly be a prehistoric one. We'll put the alligator gar, the coelacanth, you know, like we'll put all the revival small marine animals in there, maybe even the Jurassic Crest coelacanth as well. All of those will go in the cylindrical tank, but then I'm thinking we cover up most of the water here, and in the back we kind of do a semi-circle indoor area that's like in inner tanks. So I actually forgot about this, but we do, I believe, is it the yep, we have the Orthocanthus, which is a prehistoric shark, and I'd completely forgotten about that one. But since we have the Orthocanthus, we can use that, Henotis. I was even maybe thinking Nautilus as well, or some other creature, and we basically just have three or four tanks going along the very back here. I mean, if we dig out this entire mountain section, put the big circular tank here, we could even just dig all around the back of it and set it up to be kind of like a semicircular building. Then I'm thinking we have an entrance going off of here, and then this area will all be land at this point. And at this point, I think we might lower it a bit. Whether or not we lower it down to ocean level, I'm not sure. But at any rate, we're gonna lower it down, and then around here is where the actual tanks are going to go for the marine reptiles. So I'm thinking right here, I want to do, I think they'll work together. We might be putting Plesiosaurus and Ichthyosaurus together. One reason I wanna do this, I've mentioned this before, is just cause the caverns will look really, really cool underwater, and I think it'll work well with Ichthyosaurus, just making a very thematic exhibit, I guess you could call it. And I don't know. That's about all I've got planned at the moment. I haven't actually drawn up the concept art at the moment, so nothing's actually fully planned yet. I need to actually get some torches down here, so that way we have better spawn protection. Because right now this is not good with all these monsters spawning in the area. We don't really want that. That would not be good. Oh, the raptors. There's dinosaurs. You guys are adorable. I love you guys. You're so cute. Also, this was another thing. I'm thinking of using a similar style to this for the aquarium. At least, like, the tunnel design. Because I think this... I don't know. Oh. Thinking about it now, actually. Do we have torches in here? We have a torch. I guess we don't have torches. Are you serious? Get out of the way. Oh no, I've just made the problem worse. Dang it! Stupid Gallimimus. Making things difficult for me. Like usual. Of course, so they're probably gonna be mad at me now, so I'll need to go and, get them some enrichment so they'll be happy again, but that's easy to take care of. What was I gonna say? Yeah, so the aquarium, I think, is going to be a pretty long project. You know, if you guys thought the, whatchamacallit, if you guys thought this area was a long time building, the aquarium's gonna take even longer. Again, it's actually the inverse of last time. Last time was a decent amount of excavation, but it was also a lot of, what would you call it? Like rebuilding, because we also had to rebuild a whole ton of new, brand new terrain. This time, however, it's just going to be a ridiculous amount of, whatchamacallit, deconstruction and then very little rebuilding, actually. In fact, most of this build will just be destroying and flooding instead of actual building. I mean, we're gonna obviously put up some walls, and when I also, you see, that's another reason I think I want to do a like some sort of big circular tank. I think we're gonna move the entrance over a couple of blocks just so it'll fit up with a main tank a bit easier. But one of the reasons I really want to do that is, since you guys pointed out that it doesn't really make much sense for you to go straight from like the desert to the ocean, we need a bit more of a barrier in between. And I think if I actually set this up right, I don't know, it'll kind of look, I guess, like a portal. Like, you know, you're kind of going through a portal from the desert to the ocean. And I think if I do it well, I think it'll look really, really cool, which is obviously what we shoot for here on the channel. If it doesn't look cool, it's not worth keeping. Who cares if it's functional? That's actually something I was talking to my friends about with my builds. I was like, I can't really build anything with redstone or anything that's got like an actual function to it. I mean, heck, most of my exhibits fail around the first time through because I made them so pretty that there's ways to escape. But that's the one thing I'm good at. I'm not good at making them functional, but I am really good, at least I think, at making them look somewhat pretty. I like, you know. I mean, that's why it takes so long to get through these areas. Quality control. Ooh. Oh, so the one thing, yeah, I'm just gonna mention that. The one thing I really don't wanna do with this area is have a repeat of what I did last time for the last park. If you guys haven't seen season 4, you can check it out if you want to. It was a pretty good season, to be honest. I'm kind of wishing I'd been doing a bit more like that this season. I know at the beginning of this season, for most of the season, I've been like, oh, you know, I want a more condensed park so it doesn't take me like 50 minutes to walk from one end to the other, because honestly, that's what that park was like. But I'm now starting to realize it's actually nicer to have all that extra space, because although, yeah, I actually have to build a lot more terrain and stuff, I have so much more freedom to, you know, just take one area like an aquarium and make it span a huge amount of area. But yeah. I think that's definitely something we're gonna look for in the next world. The next world, we're gonna have to pick some very interesting terrain. I think I'm gonna go with what I typically do. I mean, yeah, this season was different because this season we built in the mountains. Usually we only build in the forest or the plains biome, because those are typically, at least in my opinion, the two easiest biomes to build parks in, because minimal flattening and such things, which actually would be kind of nice. But I also really like the mountains, because with the mountains, you have a natural barrier to build exhibits against. Of course, though, then you also have to eventually dig through mountains, and that's not very fun. But yeah, I don't know. Some people were suggesting for the next season, or I guess at this point we're calling the next world, because I'm going to use that world for a lot longer. I mean, it's not even going to be called like season 6, it's just going to be called probably Dinos or whatever. I don't know what I'm going to call it. Probably just Minecraft Dinosaurs. Minecraft Dino Park, whatever, I don't know. But what's the point of this? Oh yeah. Yeah, some people were saying I should do a desert park for the next world. And that's a cool idea, and I've definitely voiced interest in doing something like that. The problem, at least for me, with doing a full desert park is that, one, it makes it really hard to do something like an aquarium, and two, with all the animals that don't live in the desert, it's just kind of hard to get it to be themed properly. But I think we'll definitely do much more of a desert. You know, that actually kind of nice. If we can get a good plains slash forest area next to a, whatchamacallit, a desert, we will definitely build like a full on desert themed area. Like, you know, with like desert temple style buildings and stuff like that. Yeah, I think that would look pretty cool. I think that would look pretty cool indeed. But yeah. This is gonna take a really long time to do. Hopefully on Wednesday we'll be able to, maybe we'll be able to start working on the circular tank. I don't know what we're gonna call it. The tank of prehistoric life. I mean, I was originally just thinking for the next version of this that will just, you know, use the same exact creatures. And this is actually one of the reasons why I want to redo it. Because if you guys haven't seen it yet, I think it downstairs is actually flooded at the moment because I broke some stuff while I was trying to renovate and stuff broke. Anyway, yep, it's flooded. Can't really see it well, but all of the fish are stuck down here. Because I built it too small and their hitboxes are kind of weird. So all the fish are like permanently stuck in this area and it's rather annoying. So when we rebuild this tank, that's why I said 16 by 16 or maybe, I mean, I could do a 20 by 20 tank even if I wanted to. I mean, I have the resources most likely. Oh, we're gonna have trouble getting all the glass for this area. Plus the aviary's going in here. Actually, we'll see. I forgot, I actually need to do some more research on Pteranodon and make sure it actually fits the whole theme I'm going for, because, I mean, I'm going for, like, you know, the traditional kind of, like, beach theme that most aquariums have, because why not? That's what aquariums are like, so, you know, why not emulate that in this game? But, yeah, I should probably actually make sure the Pteranodons fit the theme. If they don't, they'll probably be put... You see, one of the reasons I actually want to put the aviary over here and actually continue the term the Aquaviary, because I think that's like the best name I've ever come up with for some sort of build, is because it was a lot simpler and it meant I didn't actually have to build a full aviary like last season. And I've always in the past actually, I was like, oh, you know, I really want to build a huge aviary because having huge aviaries is really cool because we get a lot more pteranodons in. But now I'm thinking, you know what? I think I'll be happy with just 3 or 4 pteranodons. That'll be it. Smaller aviary. We don't need to win any aviary competitions this year. Next season, sure, we can go for the biggest dang aquarium aviary that anyone's ever seen if we want to. I mean, heck, I'm thinking of building that park for like the next 3 years, basically to like the end of high school. So. If I keep up with that, I'll definitely have more than enough time to build that large of an... I keep wanting to say aquarium, and that's because we're working on it. I'll have enough time to build an aviary that large. But for this world, I'm just thinking, like, you know, I want to get through the dinosaurs, and I want to get through the marine reptiles, and then we can finally get on to the Ice Age and start ending this series off, this season off. It's not... You know, that's something I wonder if you guys are getting the vibe that I don't like this world. I mean, I like it. But I wish I'd picked slightly better geography, because there's actually much nicer geography other places. Also, I think it's funny that people are like, oh, what was it? When I started this whole reconstruction project, when I was like, you know what, we're going to just rebuild basically the entire park, because I'm not happy with how it looks currently. What was it? Someone's like, maybe is this just a ploy to get more episodes in or something like that? And I realized it does kind of look like that. And that we've basically... At this point, we've kind of just crammed 2 seasons into one park because I built it up entirely and then completely tore it down and rebuilt it. Oh, yeah. I don't know why, but I had this old tunnel for some reason. There's like an old tunnel system. It doesn't go much farther than this, I think. Like, it stops... Oh, wait, no, does it go all the way... I don't know what I built this for. I honestly have no idea. All I know is it starts over there, and then it just goes straight through. Honestly, I don't even know if I built that. I'm almost wondering if, like, Josh built it or something, and then... I don't know. I just managed to come across it later? I don't know. It seems like something I would have built, because... Yeah, it was underneath the original floorboards that were up here, because we had this area raised, like, 4 blocks, I think? It's raised about 4 blocks. 3 blocks. Yeah, 3 blocks. And then the floor would have been... The reason I'm lowering it, actually, is because I was like... if it's like another 4 blocks up, that's another 4 blocks I have to dig down to get it down to ocean level. And... Or like... So, you know, I can actually start building the whole thing. Actually... That just gave me an idea. I'm gonna show this. Yeah, I think I can talk about this one. This little idea that's now cooking in my brain. Hello, plesiosaurs. You guys are going to get some more friends soon, and you're also going to get a much larger enclosure eventually, because you know what? You need one. I was trying to think, you know, I don't really want to have go all the way down to water level because the sea level, because that's a lot more space we have to dig. I just realized we technically don't have to, because we still got mountain there. We've got mountain here, and then we can have mountain that kind of continues around. We could build an artificial, basically, barrier reef, kind of. Like, an actual, like, land barrier that comes across here. Then I don't really have to, all I have to do is build fence dividing walls, like, and if we only do three exhibit, oh wait, four, because I also want to put Tylosaurus in. I'll figure out where the Tylosaur's gonna go. What was it? Actually, Liopleurodon I'm considering putting inside. It's purely because I'm like, it would be really cool to have some sort of, I mean, like, we obviously are going to have the ichthyosaurs, at least at this point, in living with some caves, but, like, I thought it'd be really cool to have some sort of, like, actual, like, cave-dwelling aquatic reptile, because, I don't know, I thought that would be really cool. And I know Liopleurodon technically doesn't make the most sense for that, to be a candidate for that, but I think I might choose it for that, purely because of the color scheme and it, you know, having a very dark skin, which kind of fits a dark cave area. Of course, though, now thinking about it, a lot of water creatures that live in caves are actually albino and blind. Yeah, cavefish are... Huh. Well, anyway, guys, thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this actually, I was about to say it's a rather short. I think this has been actually a pretty lengthy episode. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you've enjoyed just, you know, listening to me ramble while we do a bit of building. Next episode, hopefully I'll have cleared out enough space that we can start working on, you know, remodel. Should I remodel the episode on the entrance on camera? Maybe. I'm either going to do that on, I'll probably do that off camera, and then next episode we'll probably just come in and begin either the digging out of or the actual building of the circular tank. I'm going to have to move the Henotis somewhere else. I don't know where I'm going to put them. I don't actually know where I'm going to put them when we actually build the area. Of course I know where I'm going to put them. I'm going to put them back here. Oh boy, I'm just nearly jumped down there. Well, anyway, guys, thank you again for watching. Hope you've enjoyed. And until next time, see ya.